So it's the end of the semester and tomorrow is moving out day. So everybody's busy packing their stuff, getting ready to check out. Honestly, the last 4 months flew by really quickly. It just felt like yesterday that we were checking in. But here we are already at the end of the semester. I'm really gonna miss everyone on this floor because next semester we are moving to a different level and so our neighbors will be different again. So I have to leave in a few hours, so I really should get packing. But before I do that, I wanted to do a quick room tour because I wanted to kind of remember how my room layout was like and also to show you guys how I designed my room this semester so that maybe you can take some inspiration. Let me show you my room. So my room is here all the way at the end of the corridor. And right outside I have my shoes. And this is the view out the window. And this is my room. So it's tradition for everyone to chow each other's door at the beginning of the sem. So a lot of this might be inside jokes that y'all probably don't understand, but it's still quite nice that each person gets their own custom door. So I went for the tech minimalist setup. If you watch some of those minimal desk setup videos, some of these items might look familiar to you. I realized I don't really need a lot of things, so I only brought in what's essential and some decorative items just to make the place a little more cozy. So to the right of the room when you enter is the wardrobe, and I think the wardrobes here are really spacious. There's plenty of space to put your clothes. I really don't have a lot of clothes, and this might be triggering for some people because some people can't stand hangers that are of different colors, but for me, I don't care, so it's fine. And over here, I have some of my laundry bags, and this is where I also keep my bag and my camera bag. So inside the wardrobe, there's this cabinet which I use to hide away some of my stuff. So for example, on the top, I have my tech items like my camera and my portable speaker. And on the bottom, I have some cleaning supplies and toiletries, and also some boxes that I have nowhere else to put. And also on the door, there's this mirror which you can use to check yourself out. So at the bottom of the cabinet, there's this space which most people use to put their shoes, but I leave all my shoes outside, so I use this space to hide away some of my boxes. To the left of the cabinet, there's this shelf which I use to display some of my items. I really don't like clutter, so I've kept it really simple. On the top shelf, I have this Mickey that one of my friends got for me from London. On the next shelf, I have a fake plant from IKEA. Here, I have a tissue box holder from Muji that I'm not sure if Muji still sells this, but I really love it because it's really simple. On the next shelf, I have my water bottles. On the last shelf, are some stuff that I impulse bought over the semester. Also, this tumbler is from one of my friends, Nicole. She kindly got me this Disney tumbler, which I really love. Also, she has a YouTube channel as well, so I'll link her channel down below. She makes really amazing videos. So moving on to the table, this is my desk setup. The highlight of this table is this 27-inch monitor from Dell. This is the Dell U2720Q, and it's actually a 4K monitor, and I really love it because the colors on this are very vibrant. The downside of this monitor is that it only supports up to 60Hz refresh rate, but because I'm not much of a gamer myself, I didn't really need the high refresh rate, so this works well for my needs. Powering that is my 2012 MacBook Pro, which I still use as my daily driver to this day. Even though it's been 8 years, this thing still functions really, really well. I get a lot of questions from people asking how I managed to make my laptop last for so long, but I'm someone who takes good care of my stuff, and also Apple products tend to last really long. It's definitely starting to show its age. And yes, this is also the same machine that I used to code and I used to edit my videos, so it works well enough for my need. For my keyboard, I have the Apple Magic Keyboard 2, which I just find familiar and comfortable to use coming from the MacBook Pro keyboard. Also, it looks very clean, so it fits with the overall aesthetic of the room. For my mouse, I have the Logitech MX Master 2S, which I find very comfortable even though I have pretty large hands. Also, I think this side scroll wheel comes in very handy when I'm scrolling from side to side. For my desk lamp, I have this lamp from Xiaomi, which is very clean and simple, and also I can control the brightness and the color temperature all from my smart home, which is very useful when I'm feeling lazy. Behind the monitor is this inexpensive wireless charger that I got off Shopee, which helps to reduce the wire clutter on the table. Next to that is a terrarium that I got for my birthday. Also on my table, I have this Google Nest Hub which I use to control the lights and to set my alarm. It also displays photos from my past trips that I uploaded on Google Photos. Turn on the lights. Finally, I have this iPad which I just got recently. This is the 8th generation base model iPad, and I find it useful for watching my lectures and to view my lecture notes so that I don't have to print all of them out. Underneath the table are these two drawers which I use to store some of my most frequently used items. In the first drawer, I have my wallet, my AirPods, the keys, and also this toilet card which is used to unlock the toilet door. In the second drawer, I have my mask, some medication, and my hard drive. Underneath the table, there's this cabinet. I use it to store my lecture notes and my stationery. These are actually my JC math notes, but because I was taking a calculus mod this sem, so I found it useful. And the drawer below that is where I keep most of my food and snacks. On the wall are these nano leaf light panels which are fully customizable. There are plenty of themes available on the app that I can use to change the colors of the lights. I use it to set the mood whenever I feel like it, and it gives the room a very futuristic vibe. Pretty much everyone who walks by my room for the first time talks to me about this. Next to the table, I have this lone trash can sitting there which is really ugly, so I keep it hidden away. And this is the bed which is next to the window. Outside of the window, you get a pretty good view of University Town. Because this building is pretty tall, the wind here can get really strong sometimes. And finally, to the left of the door, there's this corkboard which I don't really use, and the towel rack, which I'm still using my army towel because I think it's by far the best towel that I've ever used. So that does it for my room tour. I think the room is pretty small, but I think that makes it very cozy, and I really enjoyed my stay here in the past 4 months. So I gotta go quickly pack up my stuff now because I'm gonna be checking out in a few hours. So it's a little bit later now, and I finally finished clearing up my room. I ended up with a lot more stuff than I expected because I think I ordered a bit too much throughout the semester. So now I have two extra bags that I didn't come in with. This is all the stuff. I'm not sure how I'm gonna carry it all the way back home, but I think some of my friends will be helping me move it into the car, so that's clutch. So the corridor is kind of set now because everyone has moved out and all the doors are gone, so there are no more names on the doors. Rehan is moving out tomorrow, so if you're wondering why he has so much less stuff than me, it's because everybody made two trips, so they all cheated. So we're having one final dinner in CAP, and we got Domino's. Can I be more enthusiastic? Yeah. Whoa. Thanks a lot.